quick announcement at the end of the video. Make sure to watch till the end.
All right, guys, welcome back to another MCreator tutorial. So today what we're going to be looking at is starting a new series, which is going to last for a while. We're going to be doing it on the first week of each month until we complete the things for that we need to get this project working. First off, in Blockbench, and we're going to be modeling something today. Now, before we get started, I don't know what version of Blockbench I'm using. I usually have it disabled for updating. I'm not sure if I have that set up. If we go to preferences and then go ahead and select, I think it was under application. If you disable these two, automatic updates and update to pre-releases, disable those two, because if you don't do that, then it might update and then you might lose progress with something that you're working with. If you need to go back and update, then you can update always manually. So that's always an option too, if you need to do that. Okay, so the first thing that we actually need to do is choose a workspace for Minecraft. We're going to look at the options here. We have a Java block slash item. That's what we usually use for blocks and items. That's not for we need for an entity. So what we need to actually look at is there's a couple bedrock ones here, entity, and then the block one. We don't need those either. We need the modded entity one that is right under here. Some people try to use Optifine. That's not the one that you need for Forge. You need the one that says modded entity. Reason being is it exports as Java class, which is what MCreator needs for the Forge entity models and stuff like that. Also, it's designed for the Java edition. It says so right here, Minecraft Java, where the other ones say Bedrock, and this one's also Minecraft Java. So we need the modded entity for this one. All right, so let's go ahead and create a new model, and we're going to be presented with a projects tab, which we're going to have to fill out first. I'll be covering all this right now. First, we need to give it a file name. We have to think what we're going to actually be modeling. So what we're going to go with for the type of animal that we're going to be making is a zebra. So we're going to go zebra. We also need to make sure the file name is lowercase, so always have your file names lowercase. Do not use any characters. You can use numbers, but it shouldn't be a number at the beginning. It should always be a word at the beginning, and don't use spaces either, because that won't work for file names. You need a underscore, so always use those kinds of characters when you're working with it. It's basically lowercase a to z, your numbers, and then the underscore. Those are the things that you should be working with when actually naming files. So for this, I'm going to just leave it at zebra. Then what we're going to do is give it a model identifier. Now this is basically a particular name that we're going to be referencing to in the class file. We don't need to worry about it too much. We just need to know that it's going to be a reference thing for the entity itself. So this is also based on your namespace. This name needs to be different from anything else in your mod. So basically, if you try adding two zebras, that will basically cause issues. Always make sure that the name is unique from something else, and it's always good to make sure that your file name is something else from what else is in your mod as well. So make sure that when you're working with this, if you have multiple zebras or something like that, to do one and two or something like that, just so it's easier for the game to know which is which and you don't run into any issues. Because we're just working with this one entity in our workspace, I'm just going to call it zebra as well. Now the entity class, we actually don't use this at all, so we leave this part blank, because if we do try to fill this out, it basically causes issues with MCreator, so we don't want to actually fill this part out. Leave this blank. All right, so the export version, this might change over time. Basically what you need is the latest version that you're working on. So in this case, a lot of these other ones like Moj maps and stuff, those were for certain versions. Because we're working on the latest version of MCreator, which is 2025.1, we're going to be using this particular version right here, which is 1.17+. So any version above that, that might vary depending if Minecraft changes their Moj maps or something like that in the future. It's been pretty stable since 1.17, where we can just use this particular version. Flip y-axis, I'm just going to leave that, and the texture size we're going to probably need to change later on, but I'm going to leave it at 16 for now. So once you've done that, click confirm and you're ready to go. It's probably a good idea to go ahead and just save this project so we can go ahead and use this file later. So when you're going to work with this later on and stuff like that, you can export your Java entity, but if you don't have your Blockbench and you need to port, that becomes an issue because you won't be able to import your Java entity model into Blockbench. So always make sure when you're modeling things to save your project. Now, with that being said, we have a few things going on in this scene. We have a couple grid system that's going on. This is enabled by default. We also have, if you look carefully here, a letter N and then an arrow facing this direction. This is the direction that the entity will be facing. So we want to make sure that the model is going to be facing this direction like this. On the other side here, on this window, we have a thing called UV. That's where we're going to be making sure that our textures and everything are set up. Basically, the UV map allows us to map out where the cubes and everything are. And then through textures, we basically create a template and then we can texture everything up. On the other side here, we have elements and the outliner, which allows us to create folders and cubes, which are used for the animation process. Right. So next episode, what we're going to work on is how to actually start working with the outliner and the elements tab and modeling some stuff. And then after that, what we'll work on is the texturing and actual UV mapping of everything. And then finally, we'll go into animation and I'll cover the animation steps. That's all for today. If you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, comment down below, rate the video, and I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Peace out.
I have this friend that has their own server hosting company, and they have the lowest prices in the server hosting community, and they've given me a promo code to give to you guys. So if you want to get a good deal for the first month, then you can use the promo code NorthWest for 45% off your first month. Offer expires July 19th, 2034. The link to their site is in the description.